Dear students, next topic is synaptic transmission. What is synaptic transmission? Transmission of nerve impulse through a synapse. So what is a synapse? Synapse is a gap of 200 angstrom unit, the end of an axon and the starting of a dendrite. Dendrite, axon and a dendrite, and a gap of about 200 angstrom unit is called as a synapse. This small gap was discovered by Sir Charles Sherrington. See here, a synapse consists of two portions. One is called presynaptic nerve and the other is called postsynaptic cleft. So what is this? Presynaptic nerve is axonite and postsynaptic cleft is dendrite. The pathway of nerve impulse transmission is dendrites to dendron to cell body to axon to axonite. This axonite is called as presynaptic nerve and the other dendrite is called a postsynaptic cleft. So in presynaptic nerve, various synaptic vesicles are there and the fluid is called synaptic fluid. And mitochondria is all energy providing. Mitochondria is also present in the presynaptic nerve. A synaptic vesicle having 20 to 65 nanometer diameter, and the membrane of synaptic vesicle is about 4 to 5 nanometer. In the presynaptic nerve, when we examine with a nerve fiber, the polarized nerve fiber is opposite to a normal nerve fiber neuron, because inside is positively charged and outside is negatively charged. But in the case of postsynaptic cleft, outside is positively charged and inside is negatively charged. So when a stimulus is applied to the reaches the presynaptic nerve, breaking of synaptic vesicle occurs and neurotransmittery substance releases. These are the neurotransmittery substances releases. Example, acetylcholine. Acetylcholine will release, and this acetylcholine will be received by the receptors of postsynaptic cleft and nerve impulse transmission occurs. When the nerve impulse is transmitted from presynaptic nerve to postsynaptic cleft, the enzyme called acetylcholine esterase will neutralize the acetylcholine into acetic acid and choline. So what will happen when acetylcholine is a neurotransmitter, ACH is acetylcholine esterase, will split acetic acid and choline. That means neurotransmitter is neutralized or inactivated. And when acetylcholine esterase act on acetylcholine, the nerve fiber or the synapse will become repolarized means transmission stops when acetylcholine act on it. See, actually a synapse means, you know, it's otherwise called neuromuscular junction or interneuronal junction. And synaptic transmission was studied by Henry Dale in 1936. See, this is how a synapse function and synaptic transmission occurs. Thank you for watching. See you in next class with another topic of interest.